Good morning, Vanda. Today we are going to discussing about control system subject. So, control systems. So basically, what is in the control means nothing but any system is designed to give you a control output. What type of system it is? It will be mechanical system, electrical system, or electronic system. Any system is there, it is designed to give you a control output. If it is not giving control output, so you have to make them to control output. Control type of output given circuit. So here basically you have to define what is meant by the systems and what is meant by signals and what is meant by control systems. So basically signal is consisting of information. It may be a mathematical representation, normally a graphical representation also. Comes to a system. If you define a system, so a system will produce some output. If it is a system, if it is some input, it has to produce some output. That is called the system. Next is that control system. So the difference between normal system to control system is that the control system must have to give you a desired output. So when it comes to the matter, comes to desire or you are required, so you have to mention it with the control systems. That is what a difference between a normal system to control systems. Okay. Now, so how will define a system a control? If it is stable, it will give you a control. So first we will see the what is stability mean by. What is stability mean by? So if it, for any bounded input, system able to produce bounded output, it is called as a stable system. Okay? For any bounded input, if the system able to produce the bounded output, it is called as stable systems. So to produce any stable output, we have different types of operations are there in the control systems. Like we can define the stability based upon its time domain. We can define stability of any system based upon frequency domain. Okay? So there are different types of operations are there in the time domain also, frequency domain also. In time domain, we will be having what is called, it is time domain analysis, time domain analysis, where you are able to analyze with specifications, and similarly, we will be having, we are defining the stability in the frequency domain by its graphs, or we call as the plots. Basically, they are body plots, polar plots, Nyquist plots. So, still we have different plots are there. In this operation, we have M circles are there, N circles are there, M circles, N circles, circles as well as Nicholas chart. So these are defined the stability based upon the graphs in the frequency domain. Whereas in the time domain, we are going to be analyzing the stability by its specifications like TR, TP, TS, percent of precaution. These are the main objectives or specifications are there by which you are defining the stability of the system. If system is stable, you can call it as a control system. Okay. So apart from this one, we have one more operation is there in nothing but in S domain. Generally, it is called as time domain. T is called as frequency domain. W, we have one more domain is called as S domain. S stands for stability domain. So here, in time domain, based upon these operations, these values, you can define stability. In frequency domain, you define the stability based upon the values existing in the graphs, these operations. Whereas S domain, we have two types of operations are there. One is RS criteria, root service criteria, second one is root locus. So these are the two types of operations are there which will give you initially system is stable or not. If system is stable, how far is stable, system is unstable, right? How it is stable, all these things will discuss in the S domain. So now we'll discuss one of the topic today's session is called as RS criteria, the basic idea to know system stable or not. Okay, let's move on to the RS criteria process, how it will be and how it is going to finding the system stability. Okay, RS criteria or nothing but Ruth Herbert's criteria. Ruth Herbert's criteria. The both scientists name it is given as the RS criteria, RH criteria or H criteria. So is the Ruth format is that Ruth is nothing but Ruth is given the we call as the array formation. Ruth process will tell about the array formation. Whereas Hurwitz is there now. Hurwitz determined with its fit, finding the determinants. So using these two things now will give you the basic thing that system is stable or not. So before we discussing the array criteria, first we should know that when system is stable, when system is unstable in the S domain. So if you see, this is the S plane, or you call the stability plane. Okay. If you have any transfer function now, take a transfer function T of S. In T of S, whatever the roots of the numerators are there, those are called as the poles, like S plus Z1 or S plus Z2. These are called as the zeros. Numerator coefficients are called as the roots are called as the zeros. Whereas this one, the denominator roots are called as poles. Okay. So finding out the stability basically in the S domain by its poles. So existence of poles in S plane, existence of poles in S plane will easily find out system is stable or not in S domain. So let's see. So what happens? The first case. What is first case? First case defines that if all poles existing left side of S plane, all poles exist in left side of S plane, left side of S plane. If this done, that means whatever the pole is there, like this. That means poles are indicated in the into mark like this. If all poles exist in the left side of S plane, that time system is called as perfectly a stable system. It is a perfectly stable system. Next case is that when is unstable condition is there, if one pole exists in right side. In one pole existing right side, that time unanimously you can call that system as an unstable system only. And one more case is there to become system unstable. Okay, multiple time poles on imaginary axis. Multiple times poles on imaginary axis call as system unstable like this. Plus or minus j like this, now this is called as unstable. So this is called as unstable condition. Next, third one is about the marginally stable condition. When you call as marginally stable condition, so all poles must exist in the left side of S plane. Some cases of poles or the poles one time existing on the imaginary axis. One time existing on imaginary axis called as system as a marginally stable system. So these are the three types of the stabilities that they can define in the S plane. Okay. So when you define the system stability in S plane, the fundamental thing this has to be maintained. Okay. Right. So based upon this concept in mind, we'll find out the system stability using the Ruth-Hurwitz criteria. I told you that Ruth-Hurwitz criteria will give you whether system is stable or unstable or marginally stable. So these conditions will be defined in the Ruth-Hurwitz criteria. We're not going to be finding out a solution for this Ruth-Hurwitz criteria. We are only defining that state that the system is a stable condition or unstable condition or marginally stable conditions. We'll take an example. So we'll solve the problem. How could we test the possibilities there? So we'll take an example of something like a polynomial s power 4 plus 8 s cubed plus 18 s square plus 16s plus 5 is equal to 0. This one polynomial taken randomly. Okay. So this polynomial first you have to write with the Ruth array formation. How to write Ruth array formation? I'll tell you here. Let's see. First I'll write the maximum polynomial is s power 4 now. I'll write maximum polynomial s power 4. It's good, right? This is the starting polynomial, highest polynomial 4. So all even polynomial coordinates have to write here. Even polynomial coefficients are right in the first row. Next, odd power polynomial coefficient are right in the second row. That is called as the Ruth array formation. First operation. I'll write here. Let's see. So, S power 4 coefficient is 1. Next, even power is at s square, its coefficient is 18. Next is s power 0, nothing but constant again, right? It is a 1. Okay. Similarly, what is the next? S power 3. S power 3, nothing but all power coefficients are right in the second one. 8. Second is your s power 1. This is s power 1. Coefficient is 16. This is called as the root array formation. First part. Next thing, nothing but Hurwitz determinants. So you have to find out the data values until you get the s power 0 value. So here also one more concept is that if any row can be divided with any constant value, you can divide. So this s power 3 is there now. We can divide this particular row completely with the 8. So that it can give you a small value. Even you not divide also, you will get same output only. But calculation easily purpose will do all these things. S power 3 is there. So if you divide this completely with the 8 now, what will you get? 1, 2. Now s power 4 row is this one. S per 3 row is this one. So this is further about this one. Don't keep it in mind because we just compress into a short format of the row. Okay. After that. So what is here S per 4 outright? Outright the S per 4. Let's see here. So S per 2. S per 2 outright. 1 into this is the way to determine the Hurwitz determinants. 1 into 18. I'll write here. 1 into 18 minus 1 into 2. 1 into 2. By this value 1. So it is like this. If you say anything A, B, C, D, find determinant na, it is like C, B minus A, D by C. Remember, if these are the four things are there na, C into B minus A into D by C. Whereas this C should not equal to 0. Where this C should not equal to 0. So that is the condition. Now, if you do it now, you will get 18 minus 102 by 1. So, what will you get here? You will get 16 value here. So, this value is equal to 16 here. Okay? Now I have calculated, I just forgot about this row because I have calculated this value. Na? I forgot about this row. I will use these two things again with this one. Okay? Like, I will write here 1 into 5. So, this is the third element is not available, so you can keep it as a 0, nothing is wrong. 1 into 5 minus 1 into 0 by this one. The same format I have followed as I mentioned. Here this A is 1, C is 1, B is 8. Now D is nothing is there, I just mentioned it is 0. Okay, what will you get? 5 minus 0 by 1, this 5. Okay, so we can say that if the fourth element is absent, A, B, C, only calculating any determinants na. If fourth element is absent na, you can directly take this value B as your output. Similarly, here, so 1, 1, 5, 0 na, I can write this 5 directly under the calculation also here. Thanks. Next, that is what second S for 2 row. S for 1. So how to calculate S for 1? So now these 4 are there na. These 4 will participate in the determinant operation. So what will you get? 16 into 2 minus 1 into 5 by 16. What will you get? 32 minus 1, 27 by 16. 27 by 16 almost will equal to 1.7 will get. 1.7 will get this one. So 16 into 2 minus 1 into 5 by this one. Okay. So actually this we mentioned there is no value in the forget about this one. Next. So there is no possible of calculating this value because these two, as well as if anything existing here now, those two things will be participated in the calculation of S power, this value in the S power 1 row. Okay, nothing will exist. Next, S power 0. S power 0 now, again how to calculate S power 0? 1.7 into 5 minus 16 into, nothing is there, I mentioned 0 by 1.7. What do you get? You will get the value is 5. How means? I told you now. When you calculate any value, if the fourth element missing, the fourth element is missing now, directly you can take this value here as the output. Like this. So this is the way calculation determinants. That is what is called as Hurwitz determinants is operation in the RS criteria. Now you have to define the stability here. How you define stability? The stability definition in the RS criteria it is mainly based upon the first column of the arrest criteria. If what is the condition? If the first column is having all positive values, system is perfectly stable. If all values in the first column coefficients are positive, system is stable. If any value is negative, system is unstable. So there are possibility of marginal stable nothing but if any row, with zero possible of marginally stable, and any first any element value is equal to zero, or any first element is zero, there is a possible of marginally stable conditions. This is fundamentally to find out the stabilities. So when I am calculating the how to overcome, we are calculating only that system is stable or unstable or marginally stable, without calculating the aspect of force existing here. That is